Oh my gosh, you're so cute. We need to get your blanket changed. Are you a kitten purring and a mama purring? So we're about to go live on the Weather Channel again. Hence the necessity for a blanket change. What? Oh, did you forget your tongue again? Just need to get organized. But I gotta do it quick. Hi, Mama. Oh my gosh. Look at you with your tongue. When did you get so cute? A little pirate kitten? Hi, Mama. Hello. Hello. Did someone just hiss at me? Oh my gosh, someone just hiss at me. Do you have a crusty eye? Oh, we will take care of that, don't you worry. Look how grown up they are. They're so grown up. Here's what we're going to do, Mama. I'm sorry, kittens. Here. Look here for a second. Oh, she's a good girl. She's coming around the back. No, that's not what you're supposed to do. It's okay. It's okay. Come on. Oh, good girl. Good girl. All right. Done. It's perfect. It's perfect. Come on. See? It's like it never happened. Oh, it's like it never happened. Now let's get your face clean. I know. Your own nose. Okay. Oh, good girl. Good girl. Okay. Get the camera set up. Oh my gosh, you're so grown up. You're so grown up. You're so grown up, aren't you? Oh, we've got a goopy eye we need to fix. I'm gonna, oh my gosh, you're so cute. Oh my gosh. Let me go get some stuff. my goodness. He's got eyeballs and everything. We need to get so grown up. He's only gone a couple of days. Alright. Alright, come here, monkey. Let me fix your goopy eye. Oh my gosh, they're so cute. Huh? Look at that eye goop. Oh, we don't allow that here. Oh no. That's unacceptable. Very unacceptable. I know. Oh, it's so mean. I know, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Let me make you feel better. Oh, no. Oh, so big. This is a puffin? Oh, such a good mama. Oh my gosh, you're so big. It grew so much. Oh, you look good. You know, did you get turtled? Oh. She likes that. I cleaned your nose for you. So beautiful. Oh my goodness. So beautiful. Let me see. Sparrow, you're looking large. Oh, look at those eyes. I know. Oh, there's Perling. Paloma, you've got your eyeballs. Oh my goodness. Oh, they're so beautiful, Mama. Oh. Two little tiger buffies. How about you, little missy? Oh, you're cute. You look like you're doing well. I know. Oh, go get her. Oh gosh. Look at that face. That Starling face. Adorable. You're so beautiful. Did you have a nice vacation for me? Oh, kick in the face. You're so grown up. Thank you. That's Mama. Mama Starling's purring. She was a feral cat just a couple of weeks ago. And we brought her in with a foot wound that was pretty badly infected. And we discovered she was also pregnant. So we treated her foot wound and gave her a safe place to have her kittens. And she decided that life with humans is not so bad. So this is her last litter of kittens ever. And she and her babies will all be spayed and neutered and adopted into loving homes. You can watch them 24/7 at tinykittens.com. Hi. They just got their eyeballs. They're about to get really cute in the next couple of weeks. I mean, they're pretty cute now. Oh, look at you. Look at you. She has 6 kittens. There are 4 girls and 2 boys. Oh, what a good girl. She had a very difficult birth, so in the wild, if we hadn't brought her in, most of these kittens would not have survived. And she was in pretty bad shape with her foot. It's a pretty rough life out there. But luckily, she's gonna have an awesome life now, and so are her kittens. So are the kittens, including this one. This one is very rambunctious. This is Sparrow. She's a troublemaker. She's a troublemaker. Kittens make the best pillows, too. Oh, you're so beautiful. Aren't you so beautiful? Oh, look at you.
So these guys will all get really great homes, and be spayed and neutered, So no more kittens for you. Starling was born in a feral cat colony with more than 200 cats on a rural property. And for anyone who doesn't know, a feral cat is a wild cat that doesn't have any interaction with humans. Yes, oh, do you need more pets? Okay. And we have been doing something called TNR, which is trap, neuter, return, to spay and neuter the cats there because they're multiplying so fast. And when they're injured or pregnant, we bring them in and foster them and treat them. And then, of course, spay and neuter. Oh, my goodness, what? And when we can adopt them out, like Starling, Starling decided that she likes humans. Not all of them do. But the ones that do decide that they would be happy living with humans, we find homes for. And then the ones that aren't happy living with humans get returned to their forest. And we feed them every day and we provide medical care and make sure that they have the best possible life that they can have. And just spaying and neutering itself dramatically improves their quality of life. So it is amazing, if any of you have worked with feral cats, it is pretty amazing how far she's come in just a couple of weeks. Because a lot of people think of feral cats and they think that they're lost causes. But we're trying to prove that they are worthy of compassion. Oh, she's so sweet. And just look at her. She's so sweet. Oh, what a good girl. Oh, they're so rambunctious, aren't they? So you can learn more about us at tinykittens.com or Tiny Kittens on Facebook, just facebook.com/tinykittens, all one word. We do a lot of work with feral cats and we live stream all of our rescues so that we can raise awareness and also, it's great kitten therapy. Kitten therapy and watching kittens boost productivity at work. And it cures insomnia. So, you should always tune into our live stream. There's always something adorable happening. We are in Fort Langley, BC, which is just about 15 minutes north of the border in Canada. Although I am American, but living just across the border, so that's where we are. We do adopt out of the area as long as acceptable travel arrangements are made. And you can learn more about that on our website at tinykittens.com. Kittens. But we have adopted out quite a few of our adult feral cats. And we have three living in California, and we have them living on Vancouver Island and all over the place. And big thanks to Crazimals and the Weather Channel for putting us on. They're pretty awesome. Pretty awesome. Oh no, where are you going? Where are you going? Are you going to see me? Uh-oh. Mommy says, come back this way. So for anyone just tuning in, we're broadcasting from Tiny Kitten Society up in Fort Langley, BC, and we are a nonprofit rescue, and Starling is the mama. She was born a feral cat last year, and we are spaying and neutering her colony of 200 cats, and we also provide daily food and medical care for them. And we saw her one day with a foot injury, and so brought her in to treat her foot injury and discovered she's also pregnant. And so we kept her here so she had a safe place to have her last litter of kittens ever. Right? No more kittens? And in the process of treating her foot and getting ready to have kittens, she decided that humans weren't so bad after all. And so she's going to get to go to a home in addition to her kittens. We've had some pretty good success socializing our adult feral cats in the colony.
You are out. Where are you going, Miss Sparrow? What are you doing?
So they were born on the 14th, so they're 11 days old. So their eyes have just opened in the last couple of days, and
hi, Mama. Oh, it's so cute.
And they're starting to walk around a little bit more. But if you can imagine what they're going to be like in another couple of weeks, it's going to be pure chaos. Pure kitten chaos.
Hi, Wren. Here's a Wren. Do you want this? She's so good with me handling her kittens. You're a good girl, aren't you? Such a good mama. So sweet.
If you go to our website, tinykittens.com, you can see we're documenting all of our work with feral cats, because we're doing a lot of things that that are considered impossible, and so we're trying to raise awareness about more compassionate ways to care for feral cats and the sorts of things that are possible with a kind of a different approach. So if you're interested, we're documenting stuff at tinykittens.com. We've had pretty good success with even adult, aggressive adult males that are injured. We've been able to treat and return, or in some cases adopt out. Right, you get it. You get it, little mama. You're so sweet. Look at those little toes. She's got a great purr. What are you doing? What are you doing down there? This is her second litter of kittens. We try to trap them before they have kittens, obviously, or before they get pregnant, but it's pretty hard. Some of them are pretty smart about avoiding traps, and they can be pretty elusive. So we finally, when she was injured, we were able to trap her. And she was already pregnant at that time. But it was the last, she was only 16 months old and pregnant with her second litter of kittens. And now these kittens, the four girls could get pregnant as early as 4 months old. So you can see how cat overpopulation gets so out of control when you don't spay and neuter. Right? Oh, look at that little wobbly kitten. Starling is doing a terrific job feeding them and making them nice and plump. Nice and round kittens, healthy kittens. Healthy but kind of annoying. Poor mama, she's such a good mama. She's a good mama. Your babies love you too, don't they? They love you so much. She is extremely trusting with me, especially considering she was feral and had not had contact with humans a couple of weeks ago before we brought her in. She's really come a long way. So I do interact with her, and I do handle the kittens just to keep encouraging her to feel safe and to continue to progress in her trusting me, and it's working quite well. You can hear her non-stop purr. She's so sweet. Oh no, look at his belly. Oh, someone's trying to steal his spot. Oh no, I didn't make him squeak. You're being noisy. Nearly 100% of feral cats like Starling are euthanized when they're admitted to shelters. And that's why it's really important to be able to showcase cats like Starling, who, with a little bit of time and care and love, become just so sweet. And even the ones that aren't ready for life with humans are able to be medically treated and then returned, and they live very happy, healthy lives. We'd love to adopt them all out, but that's not always what's best for them. But the ones that we can, we sure do.
We do, don't we? You're one of the lucky ones.
You're one of the lucky ones. Get these little hooligans.
Those little hooligans, aren't they?
Yep, she will definitely be adoptable.
So beautiful. Sometimes she forgets to put her tongue away.
Not sure what's going on down here. Some sort of an epic kitten battle.
What are you doing?
Tell Sloane's story. Sloane was our first feral pregnant cat that we brought in. And when we first started, we didn't know. We had read all this stuff. There's some great information on how to do trap, neuter, return with feral cats, to spay and neuter them. But there's no information about how to care for them. And we didn't know if it was possible because they're wild animals that don't. They don't see us as friends, they see us as predators, just like any other wild animal. And Sloane was our first one that came in pregnant, and we made her a little forest so she would feel comfortable, and she had her kittens here, and her kittens all got adopted out. She was spayed and was very, very happy to be returned to the forest to all of her friends. And then a year later, she decided that she would like to live with humans. And so she came back in and went to a wonderful home. And is living happily ever after. Probably Starling's Auntie Sloane. They're kind of all related to each other. But you guys can watch. You can watch these kittens live 24/7 at tinykittens.com. So if you love kittens and you're thinking about letting your cat have kittens, I would recommend becoming a foster parent for your local shelter or rescue, and then you can spay and neuter your cats, and you can save the life of a mama cat who's already out there and pregnant and needs help. And many shelters don't have space for them, and so foster parents can bring home a pregnant mama cat or some baby kittens that need help and raise them till they're ready to be adopted, and then prepare them for wonderful lives. that's an awesome way to have kittens around and be part of the solution. And if you're allergic to kittens, you can just watch them on our live stream. These little toes. So they're about at the age where they're going to start playing and interacting and being really adorable. Where are you going, Egret? Where are you going? You've got places to be. You want the miracle kitten story? Oh, look at Sparrow is posing for you. Okay, so Cassidy is also from this feral colony that Starling came from. He lost both of his back legs shortly after he was born. And survived somehow for 9 weeks out in the forest until we rescued him. And he was really sick and starved and in terrible shape, and but he really wanted to live, and he fought so hard to live, so we gave him a chance and did everything we could to help him, and he's doing great now. We're waiting to get him some bionic legs so that he will be able to scamper on all four legs. Right now he sort of scoots with his front legs, but he's not in any pain right now, and he is very much loved, and so he's quite happy that he's alive. You can follow him on Tiny Tuxies on Facebook. The page is Tiny Tuxies, the Miracle Kitten. He's pretty awesome. Uh-oh, we're out of milk. We're out of milk. If anyone needs help spaying and neutering, you can contact your local SPCA or shelter, and most of them have low-cost or free spay-neuter programs and are super happy to help. Oh, someone's having some good dreams. So we've had lots of really great feral cats come in from this colony. Starling, this is Starling, in case you missed that part, this little mama. Her grandmother, Sky, we brought in. She showed up one day, and she's blind in one eye completely, and then partially blind in the other eye, and pregnant, and we knew that she would not survive very long being blind and pregnant, and so we brought her in, and it's a good thing we did, because she ended up needing a C-section. And then we discovered that she had she has heart disease and was in congestive heart failure. And we couldn't give up on her when she needed us most, so we pushed through it and we got her the right meds, and we didn't know if we'd be able to find her a home, but we did. We found her the most amazing home, and now she's like the most lucky, loved, spoiled cat in the world. a cat that anywhere else would have been euthanized because she, you know, she's blind and she's got heart disease, and many people think of those cats as not worth saving, and we feel differently and are trying to prove that by saving the really lost cause cats and then giving them awesome lives.
Oh, there's someone sleep nursing over there.
So you can learn about, if you want to know more about any of these cats, you can just go to tinykittens.com. We have a bunch of case studies. We're hoping to show people how awesome feral cats are. And how much better their lives are once they're spayed and neutered.
Oh, look at that face. Oh, so cute.
They think mom makes a very comfortable bed. Starling is super sweet. She was very fearful when she first came in. She's still a bit fearful, but we're working on that. And she's made remarkable progress. Just allowing me in the same room with her kittens is a big deal for a feral cat.
Is she gonna go somewhere? Oh, she's just turning around.
And people ask all the time, what's the one thing they can do to help cats? And it's spaying and neutering. But there are lots of other ways too. You can volunteer at your local rescue. You can donate. There are never enough resources. You can take care of the feral cats in your neighborhood. Are you going to come see me? Are you going to come see me? You should, that would be so nice. She hears there's some voices outside she's hearing. She might go check it out. Oh, what a good girl. Such a good girl. Some rowdy people out there. They're rowdy, aren't they? Oh, she said don't stop. Don't stop. That was a good flop. That was a good flop you did. She is too sweet. Also this. Look. She said that no one said I could stop petting her. Look at that little tongue. A lot of kittens everywhere. Look, we all have our tongues out right now. Too cute. This is Sparrow. Oops, I can't see my finger. This is Sparrow. Hi, Mama. Oh. This is Puffin. Paloma. Wake up. This is Egret, Wren, and Magpie. That was noisy and unexpected, wasn't it? Sorry, everybody. Goodness. Oh my gosh, you just have to see this. Pardon my camera work in advance. It's Magpie having some exciting dreams. Oh, Maggie, you are having quite the exciting dreams, aren't you? So if you're just tuning in, we are a rescue called Tiny Kitten Society. You can learn more about us at tinykittens.com. And Starling is the mom. She comes from a feral cat colony with more than 200 cats in it. We've been spaying and neutering the cats in her colony. And she came in with a wounded foot, and we discovered she's also pregnant, so we kept her here so she could have her kitten somewhere safe. And then she will be spayed, and all her kittens will be spayed and neutered, and then they will all be adopted into wonderful homes. Oh, she's so beautiful. Too cute. Oops. So Starling was born a feral cat, which is a wild cat that has no contact with humans. And throughout the process of us treating her foot injury and getting her ready to have her kittens, she turned into a house cat, which happens more often than you would think with the feral cat. Some of them are predisposed to enjoying life with humans and some aren't, but we've found quite a few of them turn into just the sweetest, most loving cats, and it doesn't take too long too with a lot of them. Oh, she's so happy. She's so sweet.
What a good girl.
So a lot of people don't believe that she was once a feral cat, but we know because she showed up as a kitten and she's been there for we've been trying to trap her for a year and finally got her. You're so cute. And she won't be going back to the forest. Nope. She gets to go to a home. A very lucky home. She is 16 months old. And this is her second litter of kittens. We weren't able to trap her before her first litter. Oh, kittens make the best pillows. They make the best pillows. They do. She has a great purr. She tries to bring me back when I move my hand away. More pets. Oh, magpie's waking up. Look how cute she is. Oh, she's so cute. Thank you to everyone who has tuned in, and a huge, huge thanks to Crazy Moles and the Weather Channel for having us on. You guys are awesome. Supporting animal rescue and helping to raise awareness about spaying and neutering and kitten therapy. And these adorable kittens. Oh, they're so cute. You can watch them. He's so cute. You can watch them live 24/7 at tinykittens.com. Did you just fall asleep? That's not very comfortable. You can watch them live 24/7 at tinykittens.com. We have this live stream going all the time. Egret just fell asleep on my hand. With his eyes open. I make a comfy pillow too. Let's see if I can make him a bit more comfy. You wake up. Go see your little friends. Things are going to get really adorable in the next couple of weeks as these guys get bigger and more rambunctious. Lots of people watch kitten cams at work, and it definitely boosts productivity. So, you know, try tomorrow when you get to work, just put on the kitten cam at tinykittens.com, and your Monday will be at least 5,000% better. Did you just squeak? These little troublemakers. So I think our time's almost up, but you are welcome to keep watching at tinykittens.com. And, you can see these guys grow up. You can follow along on Facebook at Tiny Kittens. All one word. Mama. The twingers have reunited back there. They're 11 days old today. Their eyes opened early. Usually it's between 7 and 14 days, but they started opening around day 4. What do you think?
Oh gosh. You know we can get through an hour without that. Thank you guys for tuning in. Oh my goodness. Mommy has to go to the toilet right now. I won't distract you. You can go this way if you want to. She's gonna take a little break. And if you need help spaying and neutering, contact your local rescue or SPCA, and most of them have free or low-cost spay-neuter programs and are happy to help. What's going on back here? Oh, this is very cute back here. Do we see some? Hi. Oh, so sleepy. So sleepy. Here, show everyone your cute little toes. Oh. Thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you Crazimals and the Weather Channel. Kittens. Okay. Your mommy's having a little snack. Oh, we do hiccups. Hiccups. So cute. This is your mama's fluff. Mama's back. Hi, Mama. Hello. Oh, it's so clean. Yeah, a little snack. All right, and that's a wrap. All right.
I just got home, so I'm going to go see Puppy Pups, and then we're going to vaccinate Ramsey's and do some stuff there. So I'll be back later on.